Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Lucie and I'm a parenting and lifestyle YouTuber and blogger. I don't know if I can call myself a blogger anymore. I don't really write on my blog very much. So in today's video, I have got a ton of stuff that I have bought lately. Well, I say a ton of stuff, and when I say lately, I mean over the last like few months. I haven't just gone and gone on some massive rampage and bought loads of stuff. But instead of a favourites, I thought that I would just do a stuff I bought lately. Just because I can't really call them all favourites, but I just thought I'd show you the things I bought because I like them, and I like watching these kind of videos. So very first on my list, I actually bought this 3 months ago. That's very precise, isn't it? I just know it was about 3 months ago. And it is the Olaplex system. And if you've not heard of Olaplex before, I'm not going to give you loads of technical, like, splurge because I have no idea really, but all I know is that it is like a bonding shampoo and conditioning set, and it repairs and strengthens, reading off the package here, and hydrates all hair types. It's particularly good for bleached hair, like I have bleach in my hair, coloured hair, hair that just needs repairing. And basically I use this, not on every wash because I find it too heavy, but I use this probably every other wash or once a week, and I wash my hair 2 or 3 times a week. And the other washes I use, L'Oreal Serie Expert, just in case you're wondering, it's amazing. But I find that my hair just dries incredible with this. It feels like there's absolutely no frizz and I just feel like it's doing something. It is very pricey. I'm going to pop a link to it below. I was considering it for like years, and I think you used to only be able to get Olaplex or Olaplex in salons, but you still can get a really good treatment from them in a salon, but they now do a range that you can use at home. I think this is called their 5-step treatment or 6-step treatment, something like that. I've got number 5, number 4, and I think I've got number 3 in my shower, which is a pre-shampoo conditioning thing, but I've just left it up there for some reason. But this is just the shampoo and conditioner. You use like the tiniest amount, like these bottles look really small for the price, but you literally use the tiniest amount and it literally lathers up like there's no tomorrow. It smells really tropical and I just think it's really, really good. So if you've got hair that you're just not feeling, it's feeling a bit like drab and it's breaking and doesn't feel strong, then this stuff is for you. Next up is a really recent buy. I bought this 2 weeks ago and actually I have hit ban already. I bought this upon the recommendation of my favourite Instagrammer of all time, big statement, Beth Sandland, who is a travel digital person. She basically does Instagram and blogs about travel and lifestyle and all of that sort of stuff, and I just love her, and she recommended this. She said it's a amazing heavy duty moisturiser. It's actually called a heavy duty moisturiser. It's got hemp in it, and I suffer from really dry skin, really dry legs in particular, and also psoriasis, and literally the first time I used this my legs felt incredible for about 3 days. So I find that I only have to use this every other day if that, and I just slather it all over my body. My body feels like really moisturized without feeling greasy, and I just adore it. It's probably the best body moisturizer I've ever used, and so I'm literally going to go and stock up again. I don't think it's great sort of cost per use because it's not like the most expensive body moisturizer, but I feel like this tub just is not big enough to be a body moisturizer, if that makes sense. Like I said, I got this 2 weeks ago and I've already hit pan, so yeah, I am going to definitely have to stock up on this. Something I've also recently bought and only used one of, hence why they're still in the packet, is these Andrew Fitzsimmons, whoever he is, little satin wrap scrunchies. So the scrunchies are made of satin, which is obviously meant to be better for your hair. It doesn't tug on it. These are from Primark. They were only £2 and I've seen similar things to this that are a lot more expensive. So I thought I would give these ones a go. They look really cute in your hair and yeah, they don't pull on it as much, so yeah, they were from Primark. So you may or may not know that I am going through a bit of a kitchen renovation. It was meant to take a week, it's taking like a month, still not finished, so hence why I haven't done a kind of kitchen tour yet. But I have been buying a few things for the new kitchen. We have gone for a grey theme, but I want to put a few pops of colour in there, so some greens and some pinks. And I saw a terrazzo, I think that's how you say it, terrazzo chopping board on Katie Ellison's Instagram when she posted a picture of her new kitchen, and I literally hunted down the exact one. And then I saw this one that was in the sale. So Katie has a round one and I went, this is so heavy, I went for this rectangular one because it was down from £65 to 15 quid. So I was literally like, I am 100% getting that. It's not the kind of board I would ever use. It's way too heavy to even like be picked up and washed, but it's definitely great for decoration. And I just absolutely love the design, and it goes in our kitchen really nicely. It's from Habitat. If I can find it, I will link it below, but it was in the sale, so I don't know if they have any more. Something else I bought from my kitchen, you might have seen it in my IKEA haul, was this pot, but I just really like it. Again, it adds like a really nice pop of pink in our kitchen. And I bought these from, where did I get these from? Oh, I bought these in Sainsbury's. Yes, I did. Sainsbury's had like a bit of a sale on all their faux flower stuff. So this is faux or fake eucalyptus. It kind of doesn't sit in this pot that well because it kind of moves around and flops to one side. So I feel like I need to get a few more sprigs, but I really like how it looks in this pot. I feel like the pink and the green goes really nicely, and I just like it on my kitchen table, and I can't kill this, so that's a win. On to a few clothing items. So recently I've been really into like really slouchy clothing. Like, I feel like this denim shirt is really like manly and slouchy and comfortable, and I just want to wear trainers and just be really cozy but cool. And I've been seeing a lot of people wearing like hoodies and coats, and I just think it looks so kind of like chic even though it's a hoodie. So I bought a couple of hoodies. One is in the wash, so I can't show you, but it's from the same company. It's pretty much exactly the same, but it's beige. This one I haven't actually worn yet, but I think I might wear it later when I'm off to a spa. But yeah, it's just a hoodie. It's in a blush pink. It's picking up quite a bright pink, but it's not. It's kind of more of a dusky rose pink. And yeah, it's just an oversized hoodie, and it's by a brand called Weekday, which I bought on ASOS. It was really inexpensive. I will pop a link below if I can find it. Like I said, I have got this in like a creamy beige colour, but instead of being like a normal hoodie, it's got like splits on each side, which I really like, just to make it a little bit more interesting. And yeah, like I said, I've just been enjoying wearing hoodies at the moment, keeping warm and just feeling quite cool. And then to go with my like sports chic look right now, I bought these trainers. Now, when I first saw these online, I was like, can I pull those off? I ordered them. I think they look a little bit like Balenciagas. Yeah, I kind of bought them for Paris. I thought I need a comfy pair of trainers. They are so comfortable. They're literally light as air. I wish I could kind of show you how light. They are chunky, but not too chunky. I don't feel like silly in them. I do feel like I'm dressing a little bit like my 15-year-old niece, but I just really like them. They're quite scuffed up. I feel like I need to give them a little bit of a magic eraser. But yeah, they were really inexpensive compared to a lot of chunky trainers. They're not designer. They are, oh, they've got this snake print and metallic bit as well, which is just a nice touch. They are from Stradivarius, which is one of my all-time favourite shops now. I believe they are a branch of Zara, another kind of sister company. So it's very similar to Zara, slightly lower price point. And yeah, I just love everything from there, and I love these. So I might as well show you something else I got from Stradivarius, which I've had loads of comments on actually. I've got two of these in different prints, and it's this dress. I will insert a picture of me wearing it when I went to Paris, but as you can see, it's a really floaty like smock dress. It's kind of tiered. I don't know how well you can see that. It gathers in here and at the bottom with frills. This isn't ironed, and you can totally get away without ironing it because it's got the frills and so much pattern, and it's got a collar and it is buttoned all the way down. Just feel like you could do so much with this dress. You could wear a jumper over the top of it, you could wear it with tights and boots, you could wear bare-legged with heels. It's just so versatile, and I thought it would take me through from kind of like this spring type coldish weather to summer, and I just really really love it. I've also got it in a green, I'll pop a picture up now of that one, green like khaki with black polka dots. The only thing with that one is, again, it's that really creasy material, and you can really tell when I haven't ironed that one compared to this one, which is a little bit annoying, but I still really like it. Again, they weren't too expensive, and I will pop a link to them below. So I am a huge Method fan, and they have recently released, well, I think these are a recent release because I haven't seen them before, some hand soaps. This is the sweet coconut flavour, and it smells so good. I actually picked this up when I was out on the hunt for anti-bac because of this coronavirus. There is just no anti-bac anywhere. I don't know if it's the same for you. Let me know if you've got a link to some anti-bac that doesn't cost £30, because I've been looking on eBay and Amazon and people are selling them for like a ridiculous amount of money. I managed to go through like 6 handbags and found about 7 anti-bacs, so I think we're good for a while, but I would like to stock up on some like pump ones for the home as well. But anyway, long story short, I picked this up when I was looking for the anti-bac, and it just looks like a really nice soap, and it smells nice, and it's plant-based as well, and Method stuff is always really like cruelty-free and lovely, so I don't mind buying it. I picked up this candle a few weeks ago in TK Maxx. I must say, it smells divine when you just smell it kind of with the lid off and you leave it on the side. It smells lovely, but when I'm burning it, I can't smell it that much, which is a pet hate of mine with candles, but I love the colour of this, and I bought it again to go in our kitchen, and we've got all these like pink accessories in there, and it just looks really nice on the side, even though it doesn't smell incredible. You can smell it, don't get me wrong, and it definitely takes that kind of cooking smell away, but it's definitely not the strongest candle out there. I've got these to show you. Now, I just wanted to show you these because I can't do a Primark haul because I haven't really bought that much in there lately. I'm feeling a bit uninspired with Primark, mainly because it's just that funny time of year, isn't it? You can't really buy, you don't really want to buy like all the kind of like summery spring clothing because it's still going to be cold here for quite a long time. And obviously that's what the majority of stuff is at the moment. But there's also loads of like wintry knitwear, which I don't want to buy because it's going to be spring summer soon. So yeah, I picked up these pajamas. I was actually lusting after these for quite some time now, but when I went in there to first buy them, they were quite expensive. Like the top on its own, let me show you, sorry, this is not done up. The top on its own, it's like a short sleeved satin shirt, was £10, and the bottoms were £10 as well. And I just thought that was a little bit steep for Primark, £20 for pajamas. But I got these in the sale for £5 for both of them. So yeah, as I said, quite hard to show you, but satin shirt with like a contrasting pocket, and then the bottoms are just these nice kind of drawstring bottoms. They look really big actually, and they are quite big on me, but I like pajamas like that. And then the spots, you can't really see, oh yeah you can if I put it up close, but they have like these extra dots on them as well, which I don't know, that just makes such a difference to me. It just makes them feel a little bit more like luxe, and I just really liked the design of them. So that is everything that I have bought lately. Let me know if you really enjoyed this kind of video, or if you didn't, let me know as well. Comment below and tell me what you have been buying lately, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!